Great chance to meet another young gun as he continues his journey. It's Luke Evans. What say we take a look at his highlights? He's got great vision, and for a young man, he's super calm in heavy traffic. With more control and get smart, Evans drives it forward. You could watch him all day. Brilliant change of pace right there. He's 30 out, 20, 10, and you'd have to say that's...
Turn him out of perfect, right, Dennis?
Whatever you say, Luke.
Marcus, how do you think you've handled the combination of school footy and TAC Cup footy?
It's been a pretty heavy year, I guess, to say the least. There's plenty of things going on at once between, I guess, juggling, like you said, your school footy back here at TAC and then rep footy. So it's been an amazing ride till now. And I've really enjoyed being able to juggle the three, and it's just been an amazing experience this year. So I've really enjoyed it.
The TAC Cup's a very professional environment for young footballers. What do you think this year's taught you, not only about yourself as a footballer, but also as a person?
I think most of all, professionalism, especially in sport today, how professional you have to be in terms of your preparation, your recovery, always being on top of your game to make sure your on-field goes as well as your off-field. So the TAC Cup, that's definitely something I've learnt over my time here.
You played for Vic Metro in the National Championships, and some say it was a little bit quiet early by your standards. What were your initial expectations going into the Championships, and do you think it was a real step up from TAC Cup level?
Absolutely. I think I came from playing school footy straight into Vic Metro, so it was really easy to understand that the different level, intensity and speed that the game was played at, and probably something I didn't cope as well as I would have liked to early. But I think I was able to sort of cement my spot in the team and just improve in confidence and then get better as the carnival went on.
What do you think started to click in recent weeks? Say the past 4 to 6 weeks, you've been absolutely fabulous. It seems like you've got into a groove and now you've got the finals campaign to look forward to.
I think it all sort of harps on confidence and your belief in yourself. And I came away from the Nationals with a strong confidence in my ability and to do what I can do. So I just tried to focus on doing all the things I have throughout the year, doing them as well as I could. So preparation was something that I really tried to nail down on and just do that perfectly. So then leading into games, I could just really execute as well as I could.
And how have you seen the year for the Northern Knights as a whole? It must be a great thing playing finals for the first time in a couple of years.
It is something the club's really proud of this year, and something I'm certainly proud of and really grateful that we've been able to maintain consistency throughout the year, because I think that's probably one of the biggest things you need to be able to do to play finals here at TAC Cup. So especially to the boys who've just been consistent all throughout the year to stay thereabouts, and now we can really cement our spot in the finals and hopefully go a long way.
Now your cousin, Nick Del Santo, is obviously a fantastic footballer and has been for a long time. Have you used him as a sounding board for any advice? Do you talk to him about dealing with pressure, and has he come in handy at all?
Yeah, a little bit. I understand he's got obviously a heavy workload with his footy, but every chance I try to get to just give him a call and just speak to him. And not only that, but having him as a role model, someone to look up to and strive to do the things that he's done in football as well as he has. So he's just been a real role model for me in my footy.
You're hot on the radar of a number of clubs at this point in time, and pressure's only going to continue to build. What do you think your standout attributes are, and if you were selling yourself to an AFL club, what do you think you could offer them?
I think my ball use, I think I use the ball pretty well. I think my tank's pretty good, so aerobically I can run out games pretty well, and then taking the game on and run and carry to break the lines with kicking is some of the things I think I can do well.
And what's something you've learnt this year that you can impart on other aspiring hopefuls down the track? What do you think the key message might be?
Just time management and being organised is probably something that you really need to be good at. There's a lot of things going on, a lot at once, and you've really got to be good at managing what needs to come first and where you need to be doing things. And school's something important that you need to always be on top of and always keep your studies up while you're doing your football as well.